Chris, physically out there, you know, first action in a little while, how'd you feel just about how your game went? It seemed like you had a major impact in the game throughout.
Felt good. We was able to fly around, play a lot of plays in the first half. Close game. I think we got to look at film, correct some MEs and some errors that we had on defense. But overall, it was a tough battle game. You know, Baltimore Ravens, Derrick Henry, we knew going in it was going to be a tough battle. So we just, thankfully, we was able to pull it off.
Yeah, we saw your celebration after the strip sack. What most pleased you or got you excited about making such a highlight of that moment?
I think as a player, anytime you make a play, it's a lot of emotion. It's a lot of excitement. So most of the time, it's just pure emotions, pure excitement. I don't know what I'm doing.
Was this a more meaningful, more emotional game for you tonight, considering the way last season, you know, you didn't watch that game on opening night?
I mean, anytime I play with emotions. I play meaningful. I don't think no game is different, you know. Even though I ain't played first game last year, you know. Let's put the past behind us, okay.
What did you think of the job Leo did being asked to spy Lamar Jackson?
He did a really good job. I mean, we ask a lot from Leo. We ask him to play three tech on and certain formations that we have. We ask him to play rover. We asking him to be an outside rusher. So this just goes to show how durable Leo is for this defense.
Chris, what were you seeing on the last play of the game? And what were you thinking? It's not only that it unfolds, but then you're looking up at the jumbotron trying to figure it out.
First off, heck of a job by them to even get it in the red zone. With like, I think 40 seconds left to go. And it's a lot of effort, a lot of grit that was played the last few plays from our defense, and we was able to hold on. We was inches away from going into overtime first game of the year, so we knew it was going to be a battle. And it was an exciting game, man. It came down to literally the end. So, you know, that's a playoff caliber team right there with an MVP quarterback, and we look forward to seeing them later on down the road.
How nice as a defensive player is it to watch the offense produce the way it did? Obviously, there were, you know, some struggles, but a lot more explosiveness, worthy with a couple of touchdowns. From your side of the ball, how nice is it to be able to say, okay, maybe there's a little bit more of a buffer this year for us than there was last year?
Yeah, it's always exciting to see offense put up points on the board, keep us on the sideline, and then give us the advantage to go out and rush the passer. So anytime the offense is scoring, increasing that gap of points, then it gives us the opportunity to do what we love to do as a defense, that's rush the passer.
Chris, is there a love-hate relationship to trying to get the most elusive guy in the league, but also a love for when it actually does happen, when you actually do get him? Or is there just one emotion that you feel more than the other?
I think it's more excitement with that. You know, we know how hard it is going to be to bring him down. So it's like a challenge for us to try to answer that call. We knew he was going to be elusive. We knew he was going to try to make plays with his feet. And our job is to get him down, man. He's tough. He's tough to bring down. So I think it's more so of a challenge that we take upon ourselves.
Chris, I want to ask you about Felix. Getting more action than he got last year. Can you tell the work that you put in the outfit?
Yeah, I think he's grown as a player. Last year, rookie year. It's a lot of trust factors that go into that also. You got to win the coach's trust. Then you also got to win your teammates' trust. And I think Philly's done a heck of a job this training camp and more so this offseason getting his mentals right and physically getting in shape where he can answer what we need from him. And I think he did a tremendous job throughout training camp as in challenging himself every day and getting better. And then it's starting to show on the field. He's starting to get more plays. He's starting to show progression. So we just got to keep it up. First game of the season, towards the end of the season, hopefully he's hitting his peak.
Is there anything specific that you told
him? No. Listen, I only can tell him so much, you know what I mean? So I think it's upon Phyllis on how good and great he want to be, being consistent every day. So, you know, you only can tell people what to do so much is what they do with themselves, their own time, when they're alone, away from the building, away from their peers in the building. So,
hey, Chris, did you learn anything particularly significant about your team tonight?
Nothing that I already didn't know. That we're gritty. we're always fighting, we're always clawing. No matter how close or far the game is away from us, we always got a possibility.
Thanks, Chris. Thanks, everyone.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.